Yes, we are live.
Are we live?
All right. Hey, everybody. Okay. We are here in Needham outside of the Needham Public Library. They are hosting an eclipse viewing party this afternoon, beginning at 1, it goes until 4, and they will have some of these eclipse viewing glasses on a first-come, first-serve basis with a 50-cent suggested donation. Last week, we were... Christine, say hi to the folks. People, you're a big part of this. There she is. She's behind the camera because we're doing this Facebook Live a little differently this time. So we're going to talk about how you can make something, a pinhole projector, to be able to view the eclipse if you weren't able to get your hands on these glasses. Because last week we did this story. We were able to find a couple of pairs at 7-Eleven, but we had to call a bunch of places before we could even find someone that had inventory. So a lot of places are sold out of these glasses, but there are plenty of other ways that you can view the eclipse. I saw through a cracker, a colander. Yes, like a Ritz cracker. That was a thing. They said it this morning. Christine's looking at me like I'm crazy. There are a lot of ways. So at this point, you're going to have to get creative. So a cereal box will do the trick. So here's what you're going to need. A cereal box. Aluminum foil.
There are a lot of ways. So at this point, you're going
to have a glue stick or tape.
A cereal box will do
some scissors. Some white cardboard, or I think this is called oak tag, or that's what we used to call it when we made like posters in school. Just some heavy duty white construction paper will do the trick. And then we also got some regular construction paper, like different colors, because as you can see on this, we just taped both of the sides. And then if you have kids, they can draw on it and they can decorate it. And it's really cool. So we're going to start this now. I just want to make sure, can everybody, this is going well? People can hear us? Great. Okay. People can hear us. Let me turn the sound down. Okay, so first things first, we're going to open our cereal box. You want to take out the cereal. I would think that that is obvious. What? Make sure. I can't hear you. Get involved. Tell me what? Oh, okay. Okay. So you take out the cereal. Thank you. And with the bottom of the box closed, this will stay closed. You want to trace a rectangle the same size as the bottom of your box.
Thank you.
I have a pen, yeah. So you'll take the cereal box, put it like this.
This will stay closed.
Doesn't have to be perfect.
Just trace it around. The same size as the bottom of your box. I have a pen, yeah. So you'll take the cereal box, put it like this.
All right, good enough. And then you want to put that aside and take your scissors and cut out the rectangle. Just be forewarned, I'm left-handed, so I'm not very good with scissors. But here we go. So again, this is really easy. You pretty much probably have everything that you need at home. And if you're looking for something to do with your kids today while you're getting ready to watch the eclipse, this is a really good option for you. I've seen other people make them with shoe boxes. I mean, really, a box of any size will work. But like I said, if you weren't able to get the glasses, chances are you're not going to be able to look directly at the sun and the eclipse itself. So you're going to need to get creative. And this is a great way to do that. Doesn't cost much, doesn't take much time, and you're still going to be able to see exactly what it looks like just on a smaller scale projected inside of the cereal box.
And this is a great way to do that. Doesn't cost much, doesn't take much time.
Okay.
And you're still going to be able to see exactly what it looks like.
So this is actually going to be what the sun is projected onto through the pinhole. So once you're done cutting out that rectangle, you want to glue it. All right, we're going to glue it to the inside of your cereal box, right on the bottom.
You want to glue it?
Little glue stick.
Hi, Angel.
Glue it to the inside.
This is Angel, the supervisor from Needham Public Library. It's so nice to let us be here today. We're getting people to come to the party. Are you excited?
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be a good time.
Hi, Angel.
All right, cool.
Yeah.
So they have those glasses, like I said, first come, first serve. But so now you've glued the rectangle that we cut out as the first step to the bottom of the cereal box. So if you were to look inside, it would just be white on the bottom.
Glasses, like I said, first come, first serve.
But next thing you're going to do,
glued the rectangle that we cut out as the first step.
Close the top of the box.
So if you were looking inside, it would just be...
No, you're fine. We're on Facebook. Doug is at the is down at the studio. Doug, if you're watching. Yes, he is. All right, have a good day. No, you're fine. We're on Facebook. Uh-huh.
Doug is at the
studio. Oh.
Doug, if you're
yep.
watching.
Yes,
he is.
Uh-huh.
All right, have a good day.
Oh, that's awesome. He's a good guy. Well, tell him you said hi. Yes. All right. Al from Needham. Oh, no, we're okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. People are just the nicest. Doug, Al from Needham Fire says hello. Okay, so you're going to close your box. You're going to cut two holes on either side of the center. You're going to tape the center shut. So last time I just drew lines like this so that I knew where I was going to cut. And then open it back up. Take your scissors.
You're going to tape the center shut. So last time I just drew lines like this so that I knew where I was going to cut. And then open it back up.
I did. Last time we used the Reese's Puffs. Today I got Cheerios because they're good for your heart. But I don't endorse any particular cereal. I like all cereals equally.
I did. Last time we used the Reese's Puffs.
Okay. So you see what I'm doing here?
But I don't endorse any
just cutting out the flaps.
I like all zeros equally.
And feel free to share this video. That way you can go back and watch it, or somebody that isn't able to see it now knows what to do later. Let me just say real quick, though, while we're doing this. This is NASA approved. For those of you that are going to comment something like, it will burn your eyes. Will you pay for my medical bills? I've seen it already. No, this is NASA approved. And you cannot burn your eyes this way because you will not be facing the sun. NASA has a link to how to make this on its website. I posted that as well in the video below, so you can check that out. Okay, almost done here. And there are a ton of places besides the library here in Needham that are hosting viewing parties. You can find a full list of those on our website, wcvb.com. Also, I posted the article below. Okay, so once you have the two holes, you're going to tape the rest of the box shut.
On our website, wcvb.com. Also, I posted the article below.
Trying to see where the sun is. I guess it's not really.
Once you have.
Oh yeah, and a little cloudy. But we could show people with the light.
The rest of the box.
Yeah. All right. Tape the box shut like so. All right.
Tape the box.
So now you have, inside the bottom of your box is the white projector that we cut out on the cardboard. You have two holes cut out on the top and the center taped shut. Next up is tinfoil time.
So now you have, inside the bottom of your box is the white projector that we cut out on the cardboard. You have two holes.
Yes, Peter, you can use any cereal box, big or small. Can you use an actual Cheerio to view an eclipse? That is a great question, Ernie. I think you might be able to, and if you need some, I have some for you. All right, so we're going to put tinfoil on one hole, over one hole of the box, because you're going to look through the other. So let's cover this side.
I think you might be able to, and if you need some, I have some for you. All right, so we're going to put.
A lot of people might remember making these back in school, or, you know, I think the last time we had kind of a partial eclipse, a lot of people made them. I remember making them. I don't know what year it was, but last time we had something similar.
A lot of people might remember making these back in school, or, you know, I think the last time we had kind of a partial eclipse, a lot of people made them.
So, just so that it stays on, you're going to want to tape the tinfoil. And make sure that it's, like, as tight as it can be, because you don't want any sunlight getting through there. Tape the back.
And make sure that it's like as tight as it can be because you don't want any sunlight getting through.
Any second. Okay, you don't have to use a Cheerios box, okay? You can use any cereal box at all. Last time I used a Reese's Puffs. I don't know why I ripped off another piece of tinfoil. I don't know.
It's okay. You can use any.
But all right, we're gonna tape this.
At all. Last time I used a Reese's Puffs.
So now you have one end tinfoil, one end without. This is when you're going to poke your pinhole into the tinfoil. I'm just going to use a pen.
So now you have
I'm actually going to put another piece of tape
foil,
right up here.
One end without. This is when you're going to poke your pinhole into the tinfoil. I'm just going to use a pen.
All right. Take your pen. There you go. You've got your hole. So this is what it looks like. One end has the pinhole. One end is open. Let's, for example, say, I don't know how you'd be able to show this.
This is what it looks like.
Let's say, we'll just say that the sun
is open.
Is this light. Okay, you're going to point the pinhole. So you're going to face away from the sun. We're going to pretend this light is the sun. You're going to face away from it. This is where you'll look through. You're going to point your pinhole towards the sun.
Okay.
So, okay, now you see a projected view of the sun or the light that we're using behind me inside the box. It's actually really cool. I don't know.
Pinhole towards the sun. So, okay, now you see a projected view of the sun.
It's kind of tough.
It's actually really cool. I don't know.
But you need to point the. It's
kind of tough.
So you're kind of seeing a little bit of light that's just coming through the pinhole. It's not exactly pointed at it, so you're not going to see it exactly like you'd see. But trust me, it works. You look through the viewfinder, point this end towards the sun. It will project the eclipse inside of your box onto that white paper that we used. So really easy stuff. And now I have two of these. So if you need one, let me know. I also have glasses, but I think those are what I'm going to wear. So Patrick stayed home from school for the eclipse. That's awesome. Susan Glantz says, watch it on TV. Patrick says it works better with a bigger box. If you use a total box, you get the whole totality. Matt, for the win with that joke. That was funny.
Susan Glantz says, watch it on TV.
So, let's see. Anybody else with questions here? Any size box will work. Let's go over it again, just for those of you that maybe have just tuned in this morning. All that you need to make this are a cereal box, some tin foil, some white, like heavy-duty construction paper or poster board, that sort of thing. Glue or tape, scissors. That's it. You're going to want to trace a rectangle on this white paper, glue it inside the bottom of the box. Then close the box, cut two squares on either side so that you keep the center taped shut. Put your tin foil over one side, tape it around the edges, poke the pinhole in with a pen or something like that. If you use a bigger, if you want a bigger hole, then you're going to get a bigger projection on the inside of the box. So you don't want to make anything bigger than this rectangle down here, but you could definitely make it a little bit bigger if you wanted to. And then, again, face away from the sun, point the pinhole towards the sun, look through here, and you will see the eclipse inside your cereal box. So hopefully that was helpful to people at home, because if you don't have these glasses, you're going to need something else to be able to watch it. And a lot of other people were asking about pets. Don't worry, they won't look at the sun. They don't normally stare at the sun, so they're smarter than we think, I guess. Let's see. Oh, Luann says she's going to do this with the kids. Oh, last thing. See how on this one we just taped some colored paper on it? And that way your kids could write, like, you know, Right. WCV.
Oh, Lance says she's going to do
B.
Oh, last thing.
That's a bad B.
On this one, we just taped some colored paper.
Channel 5.
On it, and that way your kids.
Happy eclipse, everyone. I hope you enjoy it. Let me know if you make these with your kids. Take a picture, post it on my Facebook page, send it to us on uLocal. We'd love to see it. And again, we are here at the Needham Free Public Library, where they are hosting an eclipse viewing party from 1 to 4 today with a limited number of these glasses, first come, first serve basis. Lots of other places are doing this too. You can find all that information on our website, WCVB.com, and inside the WCVB mobile app. So, everybody, happy Monday, happy Eclipse Day, and we will see you later.